Of late, many entrepreneurs or proprietors have started carrying out business from their homes. Now, they may not be having a registered commercial place of business, but are yet required to obtain GST registration because they are selling online. It can so happen that their relatives or friends may be owning or renting out that house. In such cases, GST rules require such entrepreneurs to submit a consent letter while uploading their proof of place of business. Hi, I'm Annapurna from ClearTax and welcome back to ClearTax channel. In this video, let me give you a complete overview of consent letter for GST registration, format, how to obtain it, and submit it on GST portal. So, the consent letter states that you are taking permission of the owner of that housing premise that you are carrying out business there, and there is no objection from the owner whatsoever to carry out that business from that premise. Letter of consent is also called as no objection certificate or NOC. However, there is no specific format prescribed for such consent letter under GST law. So, accordingly, it can be in any written document as per a popular format in use that I'll be sharing with you in a while. A consent letter must be signed by the owner, who may be your relative or friend or the landlord of the building, whether or not there is a rent agreement between them or they have got their rent receipts. Now, there have been a few instances when the GST officer has asked for this letter of consent to be on a stamped paper and notarized as well. So you may still upload the consent letter without printing it on the stamped paper, and only if the officer insists, you can go ahead and have it on a stamped paper, the price of which may range between Rs 50 and Rs 100. The document is required to be attached along with the address proof of proprietary business. The address proof includes the municipal khata copy or copy of electricity bill in the owner's name. For shared properties also, the same documents may be uploaded. So how to upload or submit the signed letter of consent or NOC on the GST portal? On the GST portal, while you are filling up the application for GST registration, you need to select consent under the nature of possession of premises if it's not your own or your relative has rented it out or the rent agreement is not in your name. In other words, the property is rented out by your parents or relative and you are doing business from that premise, then a consent letter is a must. So for the premise options such as consent and shared, the letter of consent must be submitted. Note that whoever owns the property must sign the letter of consent. The document can be uploaded either in JPEG or PDF formatted file, and the size of the file cannot be more than 100 KB. Now let's check out the format of the consent letter or NOC. This is how the ideal consent letter or no objection certificate looks like. It is titled as No Objection Certificate or NOC to whomsoever it may concern. It reads as, this is to certify that I enter or type the name of the owner of the property, then enter the principal address, have permitted and allow, now enter the name of the proprietor, for operating and conducting their business from address mentioned above. I further state that I have no objection if enter again the name of the proprietor, uses the address of the said premises as their mailing address. This is no objection certificate issued for the purpose of obtaining registration under GST. Take a printout and owner must sign by adding the date and place. I'll leave the downloadable Word doc link of the consent letter format in the video description below. Do check it out. Now, it might so happen that you forgot to attach the consent letter along with the address proof while filing the application for GST registration. Then the GST officer will communicate with you via email or phone regarding the incomplete application in form GST REG01, that is GST registration form. In that case, the taxpayer will have to attach the consent letter later on for further processing of the registration application. we have come to the end of this video. If you are here for the first time, I request you to subscribe to ClearTax YouTube channel and press the bell icon so that you get instant video alerts whenever we upload videos on personal finance and taxation. If you found this video useful, then please like and share it with your friends and peers. If you have more questions on GST registration, feel free to post them in the comment section below. We'll be happy to take them up. Thank you for watching.